Hello guys, this is Bhagesh Kodvis and this is the third part of how to hack with WSL2, that is Windows Subsystem for Linux 2 along with Kali Linux. On the right hand side, I'm running an Android virtual device. On the left hand side is my Kali Linux. So this is running on Windows system. If you see Microsoft Windows Home, so I'm running this on a Windows system. And if you're curious as to how I'm running Kali Linux on Windows, do check the link in the description. I've listed the entire playlist where I'll teach you as to how to go about building both of these virtual Android system as well as Windows subsystem Linux or Kali Linux system. So let's get started. In this video, I'll show you all how the hacking is done, and I won't get into the codes of it. I'll just give the entire snippet of the code in the description just to save your time. And don't try this out on your own device or any other physical device. It might mess with your device and it won't boot back again if you switch it off. It's better to create a virtual device like I have done on the right hand side. Link to that is in the description. So the first thing I'll be doing is search for my IP address. If I type in ifconfig, the first thing here is my IP address. To begin with hacking, there are multiple ways you can do this. The first being you can put a payload onto a APK file or a PDF file or anything that can be transferred via internet. That's one way. The other way to send them links, that is if they interact with the link, you'll get control over their device. So I'm going to show you both of them as to how both of these are done. The first thing I'll do is create a payload, that is an APK file with MSF Venom, which is available on Kali Linux, Android, Meter, Preter, Reverse, TCP, Lhost is the address we copied, L port to which this should listen to. Let me just enlarge this. I'll just keep it as 444 space R, and I need to export this to a APK file. Let me just name it as whatsapp.apk. So if I hit on enter, it'll ask me for my password. It'll take few minutes, and after this I'll have my own APK with the name of whatsapp.apk. So this is just one example. You can embed this code, this entire code, into a PDF or a Word document as well. So it doesn't have to be an installable module or application. Yeah, the payload is ready. So if I go back, there's a WhatsApp APK here. This was created after running the command. I'll just copy that and paste it here. Yeah. After this, I'll install this application onto my Android device. So if I go check it out, in spite of it being named WhatsApp, this is only work up to the point where the person installs it. And after that, it'll get converted into a main activity application. A good thing about this is you can modify this into any application lookalike. So you can add different logos, different font or different name for it. I won't get into that detail right now. Before we start opening that application, what we'll have to do is turn on MSF console. So again, if you want to know how I've installed Kali Linux and how I created a virtual Android device, the link is in the description. Go check that playlist out. We are into MSF console. Let me just clear this. After this, I'll specify the exploit I'm using. It might sound gibberish right now, but stay with me. I'll explain everything to you all. So after this, I'll set which payload I'm using. It was for Android. So I specified the reverse TCP option. After that, I'll set lhost to the IP address from here. Yeah, this is done. After this, all I have to do is type in exploit and hit enter. So reverse TCP has been started. If I go back to my Android application and open the application, it'll ask me for all the permissions. This is usually how an application interface looks like once you install it. It'll first ask you for permission to properly install and function on your device. Usually all of these permissions won't be asked, but just in case if you are using a texting application, it'll obviously ask for your location, phone, SMS, microphone, almost all of these, even a camera and file, if you're somebody who you want to use that application. And once you click on your Meter Preter is open. So I got access into the Meter Preter, as in I'm into the device. Session one opened, it says here on the left hand side. So right now I can get into the device. I'll show you how. If I type in dump underscore SMS and hit enter, right now it's saying no SMSs were found. Let me just create a fake SMS. I'll go to phone and type in, hey, device has been hacked. So I'll just send this text message. Yep, there you go. So this victim device got a text message. Now if I do dump underscore SMS and hit enter, you'll see that a text file has been created. And if I open it, it'll show me details about the date of the text message, which system, the address, as in the number, phone number, and the text as well. So this is how somebody can, you know, take control of your personal Android device. If you install an application from a random website, just because they are offering some hacks or you're getting paid content for free, these techniques can work with PDFs and documents as well. So it's not safe to download anything from a random website just because you're getting it for free. So this was one part of it. The next thing we'll try to do is I can just type in help and it'll give me all the commands which I can use to access the local Android device. I can use dump call log, check for call logs or contacts, SMSs, the location, and I can use hide app icon to hide the icon of the application which I have made the victim install on the Android device. Or even a worse scenario, just because the person installed a certain application will give me access to install any random applications into the system using this app install command. Now let's go to how your friends are as well vulnerable, just in case your device got infested with a malicious APK or a payload like this. So what I can do is I can just type in sysinfo and hit enter. So it'll give me the victim device. Right now it's on Android 11 and that's how I can get the system information. After that I can just type in pwd to check for current working directory. So it'll show me the main root directory. I can just cd into the root and cd sd card. So these are all the applications which have been installed on the system. So just in case I want to access WhatsApp data, so I can do that. CD WhatsApp, and I'll list the files here. So I'll have to go to media and let me just go to WhatsApp images. So if I do ls here, so if you can see, I have access to all the images or, you know, texts or private messages which have been sent on WhatsApp. All I have to do is download and the name of the file, img, and if I hit enter, yeah, there you go. I have downloaded this entire file. I can just minimize this shell and open the file right here. So this is how I can access the content from WhatsApp. So it's not just the victim. Anybody who interacts with the victim as well is vulnerable to these kind of hacks. And this was how a person can get access into someone's device using a malicious APK. And as I mentioned before, once it is installed, the person who has control over the Android device can hide this application altogether. So what happens is, even if you want to uninstall, you won't be able to find this application since it'll be hidden from the system itself. A hacker can get access into your phone just because you were stupid enough to install a single application. And as I mentioned before, it can also be a PDF file, a Word document, any transferable material through the internet can be used to make this kind of attacks and get access via reverse TCP.